one of our friends told us that, you know, we were just too stupid to know any better. Basically, we jumped into this pool head first and didn't even know how to swim beforehand. I knew the community very well here, but I didn't know anything about how to do anything of implementing social infrastructure, implementing a school or a hospital, putting those things into place. I knew absolutely nothing about. All I knew is that I liked the area. I love the nature here, and then you know, I knew that they had this need for these kind of social infrastructure components.
Don't worry about it.
She has a broom.
Whoa!
Hi. Ethan Shirley and his University of Michigan student teams have spent the last 4 summers in rural Brazil. They have worked to provide clean water and electricity to people in one of the most remote and beautiful parts of the world.
Pantanal is one of the world's largest wetlands, and it's really a network of lakes and rivers that drives the seasonal flooding of this area. The human communities here present a real challenge in that they're very sparsely distributed. And so with the sparse distribution of people in the area, it's really hard to provide infrastructure, basic infrastructure, things like schools, roads, electricity, hospitals are practically non-existent in this region, in this entire region, which is just an enormous area that's all over the center of South America.
Somewhat ironically, given that wetlands cover a large area of Pantanal, people in the region often don't have access to clean drinking water.
Hoje eu fiz uma pergunta para os alunos, quantos usam água filtrada em casa? E poucos disseram que filtram a água para utilizar. Isso é um problema sério. Nós temos em vários períodos do ano na nossa comunidade alguns tipos de viroses, nós chamamos aqui de viroses. Dentre elas, né, temos náusea, diarreia, vômito, dor de cabeça, febre. E essas viroses, a gente percebe que é causada pela água.
The idea here is that in order to preserve this area, we have to provide the people who live here already and are living here relatively sustainably already, we have to be able to provide them with things that will allow them to keep living here and so that they can actually preserve their own natural areas.
The alternative path is well worn by now. Many residents of rural areas in Brazil have already moved to the big cities. Their experience there is a hard-learned lesson. They join millions of others living in urban shanty towns. They struggle to get by among rampant crime and broken social ties. University of Michigan students hope to improve the quality of life of Pantanal residents. They want to give them the ability to stay here.
So right now, with Pantanal Partnership, we have three teams working here that are all kind of quasi-engineering projects. We have a team that's focused on wind turbines. We've also done a bunch of work with solar panels and photovoltaics. And there's a possibility in the future of doing stuff with water turbines.
I'm here working on a kind of rural development project. We are giving workshops in a couple of local schools about how to build biosand water filters. And we're doing little like microbiology lessons about what's in the water and what are the effects of the things that are in the water, the diseases and symptoms associated with waterborne illness.
Yesterday was
the first day in the series of lessons, and we did an introduction to the water filter and the biocide water filter, and we told them, to each of the students, to bring in a sample of water from their house. And today we set up bacteria tests for them, and then tomorrow we'll count the bacteria tests and count how many colonies of bacteria were in the water.
We're trying to find protozoans in this water, and we should be able to find them, but this microscope is being difficult.
So the idea is to use these schools and not just to install the technologies that we're developing in one place and leave them, but actually to involve the people in the process of building these technologies so that they know the technologies as well as we do. They need to get the glitches out by building things themselves so that they can actually maintain these things into the future. Furthermore, the kind of long-term outlook on this is that we want the kids to go home and talk to their parents. We're also doing workshops with adults. Once we get kids and parents both involved in talking, then we're able to actually get these ideas, get these technologies, we can get them spreading out kind of on their own, like wildfire, throughout the region.
Os alunos, quando têm esse contato com pessoas de fora, eles se empolgam a querer aprender mais e descobrem novas coisas e têm a vontade de repassar para outras pessoas isso que eles aprenderam. E esse contato que tem com outras pessoas, principalmente falando uma língua estrangeira, para eles é um benefício enorme porque dá vontade de crescer e de aprender mais.
I just want to understand how other people live and how they have to live, and if I can do anything to, I don't know, not necessarily improve, because that's such a Western perspective of saying, like, oh, our lifestyle is better than yours, but just understanding what the difference is, and if I can bring a little of what I know and then gain a little of what they know to take back to where I'm from and how I live my life, it's valuable both ways.